Okay, lads, well, here we are. It's a Sunday and it's a Riverfest. It's down on the the Dorset Stour, not far from Hampshire, I suppose. It's a Mr. Crabtree ward, apparently. I just talked to a couple of lads. It's pretty even. There's a lot of small fish here, apparently. So, anyway, Craig, come and say hello. It's a friend of mine, Craig.
Hello.
Hello. Hey, just give me a little bit of a rundown on you. Hopefully, when we draw, you'll give me a bit more information.
I hope so, but
yeah,
I might tell him a few lies.
Yeah, he was telling me he's moved down here about a year ago.
Just a year ago, yeah.
And it's great fishing, you're telling me. Yeah.
It's very even and fair, the fishing. It's good, and there's lots of everything, lots of bread and tench also on the river. And
probably Mr. Crabtree water.
It is a Crabtree water. It's very deep,
yeah.
And it's not prolific flow, but it's really interesting. Lots of fish.
Yeah, good.
And it's keeping the fish in front of you, really, which is the main secret. But Clyde will.
Yeah, we'll try. Thanks, Clyde.
Cheers.
There you are. So that's a little bit of information from a local lad. So let's see how we get on. I'll do the draw in a minute and then see you on the page.
I'm
a lot more heavier than you.
It's like age before beauty.
morning everyone. Due to a couple of people qualifying yesterday, etc., there's only 37 people fishing today, not 40. So we got two zones, one zone of 18 and one zone of 19. Okay, paying every five pegs, and there's the odd section where you're going to have a four peg. So that's 50 quid for every five pegs, 40 quid for every four peg section. Okay, paying top four, 160, 150, 140, 110. Everything is it Colber. Okay, there's some couple stewards up there will point you in the right direction. There's a postcode on here, but there's a lot of local lads here. Just follow down Storebridge Lane, okay, and you can't go wrong. Okay, everything's parked behind your peg. Okay, fish 11 o'clock until 4 o'clock, pike don't count. Okay, can somebody draw me out a peg, Clive?
Oh, it was a good one, Bill. Oh, okay. It's two there. Oh,
can you open it, mate?
Yeah.
When you've drawn, if you can give your peg number to Nicola and Bill, okay?
Number three.
Peg.
Three. Oh, flyer.
Oh. Is that flyer? Yeah.
Flyer.
Nicola.
Yeah.
And you're
peg Dan's three.
Nice.
Oh,
is that
nice.
Dan's mouth?
Okay.
No.
Right. Upstream.
Upstream.
Upstream. Okay, off we go. Good luck.
Mr. Branson.
Hello there. Oh, I told him a good one. I bet I got a pack one, mate. Oh.
Next year.
Number 25?
25.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay.
Thank you. Best
of luck, mate. Cheers. Okay, well, there you are. We've just done the draw. I've just drawn a flyer for the organiser, apparently, peg three. I'm around 25. I just don't know. Speak to Craig then. He said peg 40 will be the best peg in this zone, which is like an end peg. But I'm on 25. It's a little bit Mr. Crabtree water. It's very narrow. Now, if nobody's ever fished there before, you know what it looks like. Just follow me down and I'll show you. As I said, I've only just got here and I just poked through my window now. So, yeah. 25. So the bank's a bit high off the water, a little bit. It's not too bad, I suppose. It's cut back a bit. There's a bit of a flow there, and you've got a little tree there, so that's handy. So that could be. I just don't know. Don't know where the fish are pole across there, or they say it's about 10, 12 foot, 14 foot in some places. A bit of a bay there opposite, I don't know what that's going to be like. Maybe we'll put a little feeder across. I don't know. There's plenty of lilies opposite. Okay, right. Just speaking to Craig, who I followed down, and the local lad, he said, have I got tares? I said, no. He said, I need them. He said, go back and get some off him. So I get some tares. I got some hemp, big hemp, and I got some, well, as I say, I just don't know, not sure what to do yet, so I'm thinking, I got a little plan in my mind. You know, just say I've fished the maggot and hemp, I think, maybe a couple of knobs of ground bait. Right, let's go and tackle up and speak to you again in a minute. Okay, guys, right, well, got plenty of time to tackle up. Drive right next to your peg, which is fantastic. Talk to the locals. Yeah, they've got the right to come on the fields as long as they, I suppose, park decently. But it's, you know, this is the way forward, I'm sure, for a lot of matches. You know, having access straight, you know, close to your peg, and natural venue like this. Fantastic. I mean, it's about 18 metres across. I got a few bleak topping, but they're very small ones, but I can see a bit. Anyway, as I say, stranger to the venue. I'm not sure exactly what to do. I've had little tips from Richard Trace, who's a local lad. He does well. Craig, who you met earlier, an old friend of mine. Tried to put me right. They're just saying there's plenty of roach here. But you need a bonus fish to get in. I was talking to Sean Barrett just now. He's he fished it a couple of weeks ago from Bristol area, a good angler. I've known him for years. It's funny how you meet up with your old friends only on these matches. It's good, good fun. Anyway, talking to him, and he was saying that 7 pound was the best in this section last match, and that was where Craig is, you know. So, but I've just had a look at Craig's peg, and it's quite, isn't featureless really, you know, where at least here I got a bush opposite, and I got a bay just below it. So, anyway, what I've done, I've got a multitude of ideas up my sleeve. If there's plenty of roach here, hemp is going to be the bait. And Craig just gave me some tares as well. So, yeah, there's the tares for hookers, hemp. Got the casters, maggots, worms, and the bread. When I say bread, it's a ground bait. That's what I'll be using, cupping in across with some maggots in. Hoping to pick up maybe some roach and maybe, I don't know, tench or perch under there, hopefully. Now, what I've done, I've set up three rigs. I've set up six rigs. Seven rigs. I've set up seven rigs. So I got three top fours, I think. It's not as deep as they said. They said it was going to be about 12 foot, but the most I've got across my swim is about 8 foot, which is a nice depth, really, for me. So I set up a stick float for down the sort of middle. Set up a pole float, you know, holding back and trotting through for under the bush. And I've set a waggler for going across there and maybe there. And also, I'm going to set up a little feeder as well, which I'm going to pluck across there if I'm struggling into the bay. I've got plenty of options. The next angler is miles away. I notice there's a lily bed below me. I can't see it, so I'm going to concentrate just in front of me, you know. What comes and what, you know, don't. Anyway, so I'll leave it at that at the moment. I just wait for the whistle to go now. It's another 15 minutes ago, yeah, so plenty of time. Another cup of coffee and a little sandwich, I think. Get my head down, and if it's those little roach you're talking about, then fine. As I say, there's a lot of these little bleak. I don't know if it's worth going for them. Maybe I should set up a whip up. No, I'm really getting confused. Anyway, I'll just concentrate on what I'm doing. As you say, you know, they're saying 7-10 pound with a bonus fish, or you know, could see you through. So, yeah, I'm hoping there's going to be some chublets. They said there's some chublets along here. So that bush looks ideal place. And we'll see, I'm getting a lot of these little fish on the inside. Oh, what shall I do? I don't know. Oh, they are topping. Shall I set a whip up? No, let's just be positive and let's go for some, you know, slightly better fish, I think. Okay, leave it at that. All right, see you in a bit when the batch starts. Yeah, so I've positioned the camera. Hopefully you can see what I'm going to do over my shoulder. Somebody mentioned about having a camera on the side there. There's something I will look into because, you know, obviously it's nice to see a side view as well. Maybe I can change the camera later, but there's not much room here, to be honest. It's a natural bank and there's no platform. Anyway, I'm just going to have a cup of coffee. And I thought I'd just show you something, what my wife just made. Little pyramids. Actually, they're banana skin. And inside... No, it's not for fishing. It's for eating. Yeah, so peel it. And there you are. You've got a little Thai delicacy. It's like a jelly come... I don't know what the hell's in there, but I'll try it. I mean, it's all gooey. I suppose it's not too bad. I don't know if I can put it on the hook though. Right, let me carry on. Match will be starting in a minute. Okay, match started. Put some chocolate and castor in, just with a couple of balls of grommet to cross to begin with. Settle for a little bit. Stamp in some hemp. Cut the maggots across. Down in the over there. Trucks with this, and then I'll go on the pole. Might have to come back to this. Something anyway, it's a little bleak, isn't it? It's actually a little piece. Bit of a can't wait across. Thank you. watch that bloody tree then. I nearly got stuck. The bite then on the maggot. No, didn't touch it. Yeah, Mr. Treese did say bring the pinkies. Should have. small fish.
Why they said bring the whip, because the only way you're going to get away to them is with a whip. Right, this is my secret plan here. Out is a hemp with it over the maggot. That's how it works. Hybrid. Oh, a red? I'm not sure. Oh, broke. Thank you.
missed that bite. Up in the water. And getting small fish on the way down. An inch at the bottom. Kind of feeling it's going to die a death. How's the bonus fish then gone? Oh, could have been a pike. But he's serrated the line. Snappy. You see this pike in here? I'm going to try a light float on the pole going through the water, see if it makes a difference. It's holding back a little bit. Small fish. Thank you. Okay, well, it's about an hour to go now. You know, I'd caught a few sort of at the start, then I got piked out, and then when I say piked out, I think a pike tried to take it a couple of times. I lost that one, you know, bloody the line just bit right through. But anyway, I'd just be picking up the odd fish, you know, throughout the match. Nothing great. I did go across on the waggler, and I'd picked up half a dozen little rudd, but they soon disappeared. So, you know, I've gone across under the tree as well. Yeah, I went across under the tree there, and I had a couple of small ones, little tiny things. But I've come on the stick float now down the middle, and I've just picked up two roach now in the last 10 minutes. You know, a decent ones, like a lot better than the ones you get across there. So I don't know, I haven't heard any results of anything yet. Nobody's, you know, sort of come along, and I heard a couple of them talking up there about, you know, they're struggling, but you know, it goes like that. The sun's been out, it's been quite hot here, so, you know, that might put them off a little bit. Anyway, I'll crack on and let you know if any developments and, you know, if you catch any more. Okay, the match is over, and the last half hour I started catching a couple more on the stick float on the inside, but I've done the silly thing, I tried to swing one about 4 or 5 ounces and he fell off. Should have netted that one. I didn't get a bonus fish, though. That's what you need apparently to bump your fish up, so you know, be interesting when I got, because I said I've got on and off throughout the match. I had a bit of a lull in the middle, but you know, a bit of a mixture of fish, you know. As I say, okay, just wait for the weigh-in now, see what we got. Wish me luck. see what you, you know, see what the rest. I haven't heard anything, so okay. Ah, there you go, 5'9". I went bad. 6 pound has won this mini section, but Dave Roberts out of it, he's had a bream, a big bream, and he's weighed in 12 pounds, so he's probably won the zone, I would think, for that. All right, well, anyway, not much I can add to this one today. It's been a long drive, 2.5 hours or more to get here, and a 2.5 hour drive back. So, but as I say, you know, I've enjoyed myself, but no golden ticket today for me, I'm lucky. For me, so there you go. I'll see you on the next match. I don't know whether, Wednesday, I think. Yeah, float only league on the 7th. And there's then the next weekend. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. I'll try and put the results on the end if I can, the qualifiers. Bye now.